Okay, hi, evening guys.
Hello.
Evening. Okay, so I guess it's time for the most overdressed speaker to come and talk finally. So like everyone wearing jeans, t-shirts and I'm wearing this. Looks very stupid.
No.
So basically, I sort of knew what kind of dressing we'll be coming in here wearing, okay? Because obviously all of us are developers. We aren't used to wearing formals and wearing all like leather shoes and Oxfords and going out to find clients. But the talk that I'm here to give is pretty much related to that, okay? So as I'm here to speak, one of the main things that I want you to do is set aside the notion that you are a web developer. I'm standing here assuming that most of you, if not all, are single one-man army kind of people who handle your own development or maybe have one or two accomplices, right? So can you just tell me, raise of hands, how many of you work within a team of less than 5 people? Okay, so half the crowd at least. Good. So this is pretty much for you. And what I'm going to walk you through is sort of small processes that you can put into place so that you can tap in more customers, more potential people who might be interested in working with you. Okay? Do not expect any kind of tips and tricks or some small things like aap ye karo to wo hoga and you do this and you say like that, then the people will react like that. That's not the kind of thing I'm going to tell you, because in real life, you can't simply manipulate people into buying your stuff. Okay? So recently in the last year, one of the few things that I learned from some good people is that in terms of sales, one of the most important things, in at least in the service industry, if you want to increase your sales, okay, the final number of converted people, then you have to increase the number of people you get in touch with. Because after a certain point, all of us are more or less selling the same kind of product. All of the people who raised your hands right now, all of you are web developers, web designers, okay, all of you code using WordPress, most of you might be using themes. So when someone calls up and they need a website and you go to pitch to them, there's almost nothing for you to sell as a USP, because in the end it comes down to pricing. And when you tell them that my UI is very good, some kid who has just started coding yesterday comes and shows the customers a theme and they think that yeah, theme hai, website hai, chal raha hai. They don't actually care how you make it as long as the end product is there. So what do you do in such a situation when people are undercutting you on a daily basis? The only solution is to reach more and more people, to increase the pool size of the number of people you reach in the first place, so that by numbers of permutation and combination, you end up having more number of people who are converted and willing to do business with you. Got it? Okay. So when we started out our business long back, not long back as such, somewhere around 2009, we didn't have any focused purpose as such. We only started doing it because we wanted to earn a little bit something on the side so that we don't have to call our parents up for the pocket money on a daily basis. Which is why none of the efforts that we put in were actually channelized or structured in any way, because we never really wanted to start a business as such. Okay, we didn't want it to end up here. We didn't have any of those plans in our mind. We were just, you know, assembling PCs, installing software, selling these things off, and slowly and steadily, one fine day, Shashank comes to me and he's like, you know what, WordPress naam ki ek cheez hai and I can design websites. Can you sell them? I'm like, yes, I'll sell anything. You make shoes tomorrow, I'll sell that also. I don't care, as long as we are making money. So he started development, I started selling, but since we are first generation entrepreneurs, as you may call us, there was no one to guide us. My father is a full-time corporate job guy. Shashank's father works in a government agency. So there's no one to tell us that what kind of efforts should be put in, what kind of structure and discipline is needed in order to do things better. We are just doing things. Which is why the first advice from my side for anyone who is at a smaller stage, at a smaller level, trying to make it big, is get your things organized. And the most important thing to get organized is your sales efforts. In order to do that, you will need a CRM. I'll tell you why. Now, don't get worried that I'm going to ask you to go and buy some very heavy, big ass Zoho or VTiger ka paid subscription or something like that, okay? You'll get things for free, one of which I'm going to give it to you myself, okay? You can use simple Excel sheets as CRMs and they can go a long way, trust me. Now, one of the reasons I want you to use a CRM is because it streamlines your sales efforts, okay? So whenever, if you, let's say there's three or four of you, okay? One of you leaves, okay? What do you do then? The people whom he is contacting, all of a sudden they are out of the picture. But what if they want to buy your products in the future? There's no way to reach them, okay? It maintains customer database and interactions. You need to know whom you have contacted, when you have contacted, how you have contacted, what is the current status as of today, what do they want to do, why do they want to do it? Because if they call you up and they say ki mera website ready nahi hai, and you are like ki aapka website aaya hai kabhi tha mere paas, because the guy sitting beside you is probably doing the whole thing and you just maybe didn't talk to each other about it. So small things like these that cause wrinkles in your day-to-day businesses do not exist. It helps retargeting prospects in the future. We have all seen this happen, right? You go to people, you talk to them, they are saying ki haan, we are interested, this and that, a lot of to and fro happens. In the end, they say ki, you know what, I don't want to do it right now. And they walk away. What do you do in this case? Do you just forget about them? They are a valuable source of information, right? You have to keep in touch with them. But if you don't have a CRM, if you don't have a centralized database of your customers, how are you going to contact them? Instead, when you have a CRM and someone tells you that we don't want a website or something like that right now, you can just put a small reminder, and on that day, you'll be reminded that, you know what, you have to mail this guy about this. And you never know when that might get converted into a real business. And even he'll feel that you actually give a damn. Saves time and money. Now, obviously, all of the things that I have told you right now are centered towards saving a lot of your time and energy. And we all know that time equals money. So it also saves time. Now before I tell you to go into a CRM, first thing that I'm going to do is, you can go on this link, okay? kshitijpatil.com/crm.xlsx. Write it down. You'll get a small Excel sheet, okay? Only two sheets inside it, okay? And you can start using that as an effective CRM immediately, because even I am using it right now, okay? I'll tell you how to use it. So before we go there, I'll just give you an overview of some of the jargons that are involved in a CRM, if at all you have not used it as such. Now, I'm not saying that this is all there is to a CRM, but this is the bare bone structure that we can have, right? Okay? So as you can see, under the CRM as a whole, under the whole umbrella, you have leads, okay? Now, what are leads? A lead is basically any piece of information that helps you contact a real life person. It can be a name, it can be a phone number, it can be an email ID, okay? For example, if you just start walking on the road, you find a visiting card down on the footpath and you pick it up, it has a name, number, email ID, that is now your lead. You have to contact that person to ask whether or not they would be interested in your service. So no matter where you find it, how you get it, a lead is a piece of information which can be contacted to confirm whether or not they would be able to use your services. Next is, a lead, when gets converted, okay, when it is contacted, it becomes a contact, okay? So the contacting can happen by mail, by call, by visits, or by any other medium, if you're like telekinetic and something like that. If you have contacted them and they have responded by either saying that yes, we are interested in hearing you out, or they have just simply said, you know what, I don't care about websites, I don't know what they are, internet is just some parallel universe to me, I don't give a shit, fine. that lead is dead. But whenever someone says that, okay, I'm ready to hear you out, that lead now becomes a contact. And now you start initiating your to and fro daily basis contact with that person. At the same time, the contact also, you see, on a parallel level, is an account. A contact is simply a name, a person is a contact. So my name is Kshitij Patil, I'm a contact. I work for Zetabyte Solutions, okay? So Zetabyte Solutions is the account for you. Now under an account, there might be multiple contacts. So if you get in touch with me, let's say to sell telephony services, you talk to me and I say, you know what, I don't understand a lot of technicalities, let me divert you to my tech head. The Shashank comes into picture and then Shashank also becomes a part of your contact list. But both of us reside under the same account. So if any of us leaves the company, you still have the company contact details with you. Okay, so that's an account. Now picture this, you have started contacting people, you're talking to them, you tell them that you provide 10 different services and they tell you, okay, I want to go with web development. Okay, now that web development, that's a project for you, and that project costs, let's say you charge around 25,000 rupees. So that 25,000 rupees of web development project is the opportunity for you. That's the exact word. Okay, so you create an opportunity, name it CMS website development project, and in the cost section you put 25,000 rupees, and then you put dates and further, like when you're going to get in touch with the person and when you're going to meet them or call, mail them, stuff like that. Okay, so now even in this CRM, like we saw, everything starts from the leads. Okay, now even leads are divided into two parts. One is inbound and another is outbound. The words are pretty self-explanatory, okay? And I'll explain those in details. Let's start with outbound over here. When you start going for outbound leads, that is contacting people from your end, okay? All of a sudden, you stop becoming a web developer and become a businessman, okay? So any businessman who starts his new business should and does ask these three questions to himself. First is, what am I selling? Next, who am I selling it to? And third, how am I going to sell it? Now the management jargons for these are your product, target group, market strategy. Okay, but answering these questions clears so many things that this getting the answers to these questions sets your path to getting your new clients every day. Now, when you talk about getting new clients and what I'm going to sell, when you talk about the product and what you're going to sell, the question becomes, as a web developer, what can you sell? You have to look at yourself, you have to look at your expertise. And when I say expertise, I don't only mean expertise in terms of technicalities, okay, what you can code in, what kind of functionalities you can build. I also mean managerial expertise. So if you decide to go for developing a big implementation of a hosted application somewhere, just because it earns you more in a smaller period of time, without understanding what kind of management planning and to and fro goes between inside it, it'll be a big suicide. And trust me, we have done that. We spent like 2 or 3 months on a certain project and we had the coding capabilities, but in management we failed. And we had clashes with the client. In the end, even though 90% of the coding was done, we had to drop the project, return the money, and we had lost 3 or 4 months of our lives. So when you choose what kind of projects you are going to take, make sure that you understand both the coding and the managing part of it. Next thing that I would want to tell you is, focus on one area and one area only, at least when you're starting up. The reason to do this is, like I told you earlier, not only is it dependent upon what kind of technical expertise and managerial expertise you have, but focusing on one single type of product or service helps you to converge all of your marketing efforts in that way. Okay, so I assume that as web developers, we can either design CMS using WordPress, we can develop e-commerce systems using WordPress or OpenCart or Magento Open Editions or something like that. We can also go for customized apps and implement applications and scripts on a larger level, like something like HR systems, payroll system, etc., that are cloud based and so on and so forth. Okay, so let us assume that there are these three categories in which you would want to place yourself in, either of which. The next thing that I would want you to do is, once you have finalized what kind of product that you are going to sell, it will help you to answer the next question. That is, who are you going to sell those products to? Because every kind of product is related to a certain kind of audience. Are you understanding?
Yes.
Yeah. Are you awake?
Yes.
So, let's say you are into designing CMS, alright? So, you can either target the local businesses, micro, small and medium enterprises or individuals. Makes sense, right? Obviously, big corporations have their own websites as well. But for the most part, all of the people that have come to you to get normal CMSs designed are mostly from these kinds of backgrounds. Next, you have developing e-commerce. Now, these kinds of websites are mostly needed by either manufacturers, big manufacturers, not the one who manufacture cloth, but the one who manufacture clothes, right? The one who manufacture cloths will probably go into your MSMEs and individuals, because they either export or import things in bulk, okay? Then you have brands. They might be local brands, national brands, international brands, any of them, but they'll obviously go for e-commerce, okay? Or you have startups. Nowadays, almost every kid in the corner knows how to print a t-shirt, knows how to graphic design, put them on the t-shirt, emboss them, and that's it. They have a brand ready, they're good to go, they start selling. So these are the clients that you would want to go for. Next is, if you want to go for custom apps or script, then you obviously have the big players, the corporations, SMEs, bigger organizations that need that have that kind of bandwidth, who will actually utilize these kinds of applications on a day-to-day basis. Otherwise, they wouldn't want to make a custom app. They would just simply buy a SaaS service and be done with it. The next thing that I would want you to do is, once you have finalized what exact type of development you want to go in, the next thing I would want you to do is focus on a single industry. I know we are getting a bit nitpicky, but it'll make sense in the end. Why I want you to do this is, firstly, it is easier to get recognition in smaller circles. Let us say you decide to enter chemical manufacturing companies, okay, their circle. You wanna only make websites for chemical manufacturing companies. Somehow you get one client, okay, and then the other, and then the other. The reason this happens is, if your concentration is only on one single particular industry, maybe in an industrial park or in a whole city, you can find their databases in one place. If you ask someone, they'll probably know someone of their friends, employees, ex-employees working in some other company who might need a website as well. And whenever you make a new website for an old company, you have no idea how many people actually start visiting that in their own circle, because for them it's a competitive thing. So you want your name to be there under the website. Next is, you become the de facto industry expert. Pretty obviously, right? All of a sudden, you have done 5 chemical companies' website, and the 6th company wants you to do it. Because no matter what you do, and no matter how we think about websites, each and every company, each and every industry thinks that they are unique to their own selves. Everyone thinks, like, chemical industry, though, it is very impossible to survive. Why? Because we have this, because we have that. And it is extremely difficult to make a website. But we know, right? What does it take to make any website? At least as far as CMS is concerned. Home, contact, about us, services. Okay, right? Only the number of services pages will increase here and there, koi login page hoga. But apart from that, we know that the structure remains same. But people don't want to think like that. And that is where you should take the advantage. Tell them, when you go to them and you pitch your product, you can tell them, ki boss, we have done 5 chemical companies' website and we know exactly how you need it, why you need it. So the other person who is pitching to you, he doesn't understand squat. Now, it is true, but not that it matters a lot. If you are on the other side, you will be in trouble if someone makes this argument. You gain word of mouth within their community. Like I said, these are small communities. They are related with so many things. They are in the same business groups. They are related via unions. They are related via government policies that come into picture. They are even physically located near each other for a lot of reasons, for a lot of rules and regulations. So it is easier for you to find. Why do you want to walk around whole Mumbai when you can just go to Nariman Point and find banks over there? In-depth knowledge of industry helps in future pitches. Pretty obvious, right? When you start doing the same kind of work for the same kind of companies, you get in touch with some jargons that you hear every now and then. And if you start throwing those jargons in your next pitch, they'll know that you know. And when you know that they know that you know, you'll be extremely, extremely confident. Trust me, the confidence level goes from here to here in a second. At the same time, you'll understand nothing of maybe accounting companies. But do you even care by this point? You're minting 50, 60,000 behind each website and you're getting references after references after references, and you know exactly kahan se database lena hai, exactly kisko contact karna hai, and you're probably set. A good example of this implementation is guys at MID, GID, IndiaMart. Has anyone heard of it? MID is Maharashtra Industrial Directory, GID is Gujarat Industrial Directory, IndiaMart to we know. Now these guys started out targeting heavy metal manufacturing industry. Okay, they provided them with search results because everyone needs their services. Let's say Hero wants to manufacture a bicycle. Okay, I make the cranks, you make the chain, but I have contact with Hero and I tell them ki I'll get you crank as well as chain. So I get in touch with you. So we both are in the same, pretty much the same industry, but I need chains and you want to sell chains. So to connect them, these people came into picture, and now they are making their websites, they are running their campaigns, they are making them pay to get the advertisements in their magazines, and again they are going to the same people to sell those magazines. The buttload of money that these guys are making is only because they concentrated on something and then grew very fast. Now the next question is, you have finalized what kind of products you want to make. You have finalized what kind of industry you want to sell them to. The question becomes, how are you going to get in touch with them? Now the answers are pretty straightforward, but I'm going to still list them down anyways. Okay, you have Just Dial. You know how to use Just Dial, okay? Jana hai, you try in clothing manufacturer in, I don't know, Andheri area, you'll get a whole list of them. Copy their names, put it in an Excel sheet, okay? You have their phone numbers, start contacting them. You'll have the current present websites. You'll probably get any of the additional information. Start contacting them, start calling them, start visiting them, start sending them mailers. IndiaMart is the same thing. Go on the website and you'll find the whole list right there. Okay. Join local business groups. Like I said, you have things like BNI, etc., which are extremely expensive. I wouldn't go there. But you do have free groups that come together every now and then. Even you can use meetup.com. But if you go on meetup.com, the one which we use for arranging WordCamp ka meetings, if you go there, there is a section when you go on the homepage. They have a section called entrepreneurs or something like that. You go there, you have people meeting each other just for the sake of meeting. Okay? Find such more and more free sources of meeting people in your own area. Visit physical location. This is basically you strapping on and just going to the business park, nearest IT park, or what do you have here, industrial areas, okay? And you don't have to do much. You have to go there in a business park probably, okay? When you enter, you'll have this big board that has everyone's name. Click a picture, come home, do your Google search, do your Just Dial search, get a list, start contacting them, because no one is gonna let you just willy-nilly go inside and start meeting people. There are watchmen who are paid to do that job, okay? You need an appointment to get inside. One more thing that you can do is visit stores, because we are also talking about individual and local businesses here. Now, this is one of the worst ways to do business, at least for me. Because time's up.
Yeah.
I have so much to say.
You will have to.
I'll speed it up.
I can give you an extra 5 minutes. Oh. 5 minutes.
Okay. I'll just wrap it up faster. Okay? Never go to. Yeah. I wouldn't want you to visit stores because it is extremely exhausting and it is almost useless as well. And the people who you would hire wouldn't want to do it any which way. Okay? But what I did learn was that India still has a long way to go in terms of internet literacy. They still do not understand, at least the people of this level do not understand the difference between Google and internet. For them, Google equals internet. They do not understand the concept of having their own website and how it is going to help them. Okay? No means no. So when you go to a person, at least while visiting shops, and tell them that you have web development skills and you want to sell them, if they are telling you no, then there's no need to convert that no into a yes. Don't force them and just walk away. You don't have that kind of time to waste on someone who doesn't just want a website. They don't want a product. Just walk away. Okay? The rule of three is, if you try to contact someone more than thrice, there's no point in contacting them again and wasting your time on that. Okay? If you call someone up thrice and say, you know what, I want to meet you up and this and that, and they just simply don't respond, take the hint, walk away. Okay, as far as e-commerce companies are concerned, the main way to contact them is not by calling them up or going directly to meet them up, because they will not entertain you. They are extremely big companies. So the best way to contact them is by using emails. Now, you need email IDs to send those emails to. Where are you going to get that? Now, the one way to do this is buying things, but we don't have that kind of money. And plus, they are not always 100% accurate. So what do? You can also get your email database by visiting trade shows or places like these where you can exchange cards and get people's email IDs and try and contact them later on, okay? You can either buy or borrow. Let's say you have a friend who does only CMS and you do only e-commerce. You can trade the list that you have with each other and try to contact them for your own products, okay? Next is using LinkedIn. Now, when I say using, I mean actually using it, okay? Now, I'll just drive real fast from it. If you have any problem, just hit me back on Twitter. I'll tell you in detail, okay? You see this advanced search button over here in LinkedIn? We have never used that. When you click on that, you'll get this page, okay? All you have to do is put in the, where's the list? You have to put in what industry you're looking for. Let's say you want to target someone in the retail industry, you want to sell e-commerce websites. You target someone in the retail industry, okay? Put in the title that you want, okay? You want someone who manages e-commerce for that company, right? So you just put in e-commerce, e-commerce or e-commerce and that. Hit search, okay? And you'll get a whole list. You just have to take them all the names, okay? Now you know what is the current website, okay? Now you have to basically make out what is the email IDs. So how do you do that? Enter mail tester, I'm so sorry. What mail tester does is basically validates the email ID that you have put in into it, okay? So there are specific formats of email IDs. You have first name dot last name, first name at the rate, domain name dot extension, okay? So for example, my email ID is kshitij@zetabyte.in, okay? It can either be Kshitij Patil, it can be k.patil, it can be kshitij.p. But more or less, these are the only combinations that you have, okay? All you have to do is just try to put each one of them. When it hits a positive, okay. Do you want me to stop? Is it fine if I
make it brief and wrap
it? It's a bit detailed, that's why.
Can we wrap it up? Can you give the main points and summarize it?
This is the main point. Well, let me just finish that at least. Thoda late ghar pe jaoge chalega? Are you sure? I don't want to enforce things, okay? Okay, so when you have hit the correct email ID, it'll give you a green. If not, it'll give you the obvious red. Okay, and you just have to try the another combination. When you do this, in the end, you'll be left with a big list of verified email IDs that are related to the exact industry that you want to target, and these will be email IDs of the people you actually want to talk to. You don't want to, there's no point of me giving you email ID of my company's Spoon if you want to work with me. He's not going to help you out, is he? So once you have this, all you have to do is compose a nice crisp email, okay? Use bulk mailing services, something like MailChimp, they have free services, okay? Or even some CRMs have inbuilt mailing capabilities within them, okay? But make sure whatever you choose, it has the ability to monitor your campaign so that in future you can tweak things like change subject line, change the body, or change the presentation that you're sending along with it. Okay, you can do A-B splitting and A-B split tests and stuff like that. So mail merge is a big no-no. Okay, don't use your Outlook and Word file together and use mail merge. It will doing that will your all of the mails that you send will end up in people's spam box. You don't want to do that. You want your mails to go in the inboxes or at the most in the promotion boxes. Okay. Now, okay. I think you have read this, so I'll just skip ahead. Inbound sales. Now, inbound sales is, as you can understand, when someone voluntarily contacts you, okay, sends you a mail, okay, or has come to you either by client references, references from friends and family, okay, or as a result of any of the advertising campaigns that you have run. It can be anything from TV ad to banner ads to Google search ads, but they have come to you, which means that they already want that specific product, they think that you are a good person to work with, and they're probably fine with your pricing as well if you have it on your website or something like that. So when something is so qualified, it just makes sense to jump all in on that. The problem is, when we have these kinds of campaigns running, the client comes in, but he's not able to reach you. Because as web developers, we feel that apna website to baba best hai. It is matlab UI and UX ka pappa hai, no one is going to challenge and no one is going to get lost on my website. The problem is, people do get lost on their website because people don't come on your website just to understand what kind of technologies you are using and the customization. All they care is about what they want. They just want the confirmation from your site that you are what you say you are and you provide what you say you are providing, which is why I want you to start implementing landing pages. These are your single page conversion tools. These are like your secret weapon to go all in on it. Okay. Now there are five things that you definitely need to have if you're having landing pages. First is a headline. Okay. It has to be a single line that resonates with the ad piece that you have already run. Okay. Maybe it may be on Google AdWords or it may be a brochure or pamphlet or a newspaper advertisement, okay? But it has to speak the same language and it has to tell the customers what exactly you're selling. You can also have a subheading if you want, if it's necessary, okay? Having a hero image, okay, on one side is necessary because images transfer ideas without using words and samne wala person doesn't have to think. He'll immediately relate with what you're trying to sell, okay? To counter that, you need to have a small service list, okay, not more than 3 bullet points. Tell them in brief whatever you are selling so that they immediately understand, okay, this is what this guy is selling, this is what I want to buy. Okay, how do I get in touch with you? Next comes, okay, even the PC wants me to check it out. The claps over the PC. Okay.